Hi students, I am Rajil. Welcome to part 3 of metallurgy. Ellingham diagrams. About Ellingham diagram, last section I gave a brief idea about it, and today's section I will explain the diagram in detail. This diagram mainly consists of gives free energy and temperature and delta G formation of various metal oxides. And this diagram will clearly give an idea about the selection of reducing agent for reduction of a particular metal oxide. Here you can see many lines. Now we can take one example, one line Mg2MgO. And take a temperature, for example take 800 degrees Celsius. At 800 degrees Celsius, the MgO, delta G formation of MgO is minus 1000 kilojoule per mole. At the same temperature, delta G formation of Al2O3 is nearly equal to minus 900, it's approximate value. And my question is, out of these two value at 800 degrees Celsius, which value is more negative? Minus 1000 is more negative. Delta G more negative is minus 1000. At 800 degrees Celsius, delta G formation of MgO is minus 1000, and that value is more negative. So it is very clear, more delta G negative value, more will be the easier to form oxide, more will be the possibility of reaction. So out of Al2O3 formation and MgO formation at 800 degrees Celsius, which reaction is faster? Out of 800 degrees Celsius, Mg2MgO or Al2Al2O3, which reaction is faster? By looking delta G value, can you tell the answer? Answer is Mg2MgO, because 800 degrees Celsius, more delta G negative values, minus 1000. So reaction feasibility for more for Mg2MgO. Actually, this point will help you to find out choice of reducing agent in many of the numericals related to Ellingham diagram. I will give one more example, Cr2 to Cr2O3 and Al2 to Al2O3. The same temperature, or you can take any temperature, 0 to 2000 degrees Celsius, any temperature, Al2 Al2O3 line is this one. Cr2, Cr2O3 line is this one. Any temperature, Al2 to Al2O3, delta G values found to be more negative, because this line comes below Cr2O3. So delta G values more negative for Al2 to Al2O3. So at any temperature, compared to Cr, formation of oxide from Al is more. So Al can easily change to Al2O3 compared to Cr2 to Cr2O3. And like that, each line you can interpret, and this interpretation will help you to find out the choice of reducing agent from Ellingham diagram, and more numericals based on this we'll see in the next slide. So now I will explain some NCERT interest and exercise questions. Question number 1, out of carbon and carbon monoxide, which is a better reducing agent at 673 Kelvin? Question is very clear, out of these two, which is better reducing agent? Means which can undergo oxidation easier. The best reducing agent will undergo oxidation easier, already we know it. Oxidation means which can, out of carbon and carbon monoxide, which can take oxygen and form oxide out of these two. So to find out the answer, we can make use of Ellingham diagram. So now we'll move to Ellingham diagram. In Ellingham diagram, for this question, three lines are very important: carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, this line, and second line is carbon to carbon monoxide, and third line is carbon to carbon dioxide, and next important thing is temperature 673 Kelvin. These three are important. To understand more, we can draw some lines above it. First I said this is the important one, this line, and second one, this is important, another important line, and third one, another important line is this one. These three lines are important. Now we will see 673 Kelvin, the value of delta G. 673 Kelvin, for carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, values 400, not 400, minus 450 joule per mole. Okay. Now see, so carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, delta G formation of this reaction is minus 450. Okay. Now we will see delta G formation of carbon to carbon dioxide. Can you tell the value? Values between minus 300 and minus 400. The value we can take what? Minus around minus 350. And next is this line. This one also carbon to carbon monoxide. Carbon to carbon monoxide at 673 Kelvin. The values again same, because like carbon to carbon dioxide, carbon to carbon monoxide line also in touching here, so the values minus 350. So for carbon case, carbon to carbon dioxide or carbon to carbon monoxide, if carbon is the reducing agent, value of delta G is minus 350. If carbon monoxide is the reducing agent, value is minus 450. So out of these two, which one have more delta G value, more negative value? Minus 450, that means carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide. So compared to carbon dioxide and carbon to carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide reaction is more feasible, and carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide is chances more, because due to high delta G negative value, because delta G value is minus 450, but other two cases delta G's value minus 350. I think now clear. So answer is CO, carbon monoxide is the answer. Not clear, you just repeatedly again one more time you see the video, the topic will clear. Now we'll move to the next question. Why zinc is not extracted from zinc oxide through reduction using CO? Before starting the answer, we can delete or erase all the lines from this graph. Now we'll move to the next question. Already I set the question, zinc is not extracted from zinc oxide through reduction using CO. Means we cannot, the meaning of this question is we cannot use carbon monoxide for reducing ZnO to Zn. That means this reaction is not possible. We cannot use carbon monoxide. But instead of carbon monoxide, we can use carbon. So the answer we can explain by using a mathematical step. And carbon, see, carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, take for understanding this question, take any temperature. For example, take 600 degrees Celsius. Okay, and here the temperature 600 degree Celsius. At this temperature, now we can draw a line. At 600 degree Celsius, carbon, see this value, what is that? Minus 400. Okay, now next is Zn to ZnO. The value at 600 is values minus 500. But this reaction, you see, is not Zn to ZnO. But the here the reaction is ZnO to Zn. ZnO to Zn. So just opposite of this. This reaction value is 500. So Zn O2 to Zn, what is the value? Zn to Zn O is minus 500. So Zn O2 to Zn is 500 at 600 degree Celsius. So values 600 degree Celsius, values 500 kilojoule per mole. And take the sum of both, minus 400 and 500, total sum is 100. So you are getting a positive value of delta G. If value is positive, delta G is positive, reaction is not feasible, because that reaction become difficult to take place. So we cannot use carbon monoxide as a reducing agent for this particular reaction. Or without using this calculation, directly by looking this diagram also we can tell the reason behind it. See that diagram again. See, carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide, the delta G value at 600 degree Celsius is here around minus 450, but Zn to Zn O, the delta G values minus 550. So out of this carbon monoxide carbon dioxide, delta G value less, so the chances, possibility is less compared to Zn to Zn O. So this case also, carbon to carbon monoxide to carbon dioxide possibility is less when it combined with Zn O. So very simple thing, when we take a reducing agent, for example here the reducing agent is carbon monoxide, when we take a reducing agent, that reducing agent should come always below the line of the metal oxide. For example, magnesium can use it as a reducing agent for Al2O3 because magnesium comes below the line of metal oxide. So always remember this shortcut. Okay, I am repeating, always remember this shortcut. The reducing agent here, suppose magnesium is used for reducing Al2O3. Why we can use magnesium? Because magnesium comes below the line of Al2O3. But we cannot use Al for reducing MgO because metal oxide comes below and a reducing agent comes above the line. So very simple, in Ellingham diagram, the metal, the reducing agent should always come behind the or below the line of metal oxide. So third question also you can give answer like this: out of carbon and carbon monoxide, which is a better reducing agent for Zn O? Already discussed, but we can tell this answer by using this logic. See, out of carbon and carbon monoxide, which is a better reducing agent for Zn O? See, carbon monoxide is reducing agent, carbon monoxide is comes above the line of Zn O, so we cannot use carbon monoxide. But this is a line of Zn O, but carbon, after this temperature, carbon and carbon here comes below the line of Zn O, so we can use carbon as a reducing agent for reducing Zn O at high temperature. I think these questions are clear, especially this chapter. One of the difficult topic is Ellingham diagram, so you need more attention to understand it. So any doubt, you can clear doubts later. The phone number, WhatsApp number is given, so you can clear your doubts. Any doubt, we are ready to explain it. Aluminium will not reduce MgO at a temperature below 1500 degrees Celsius, but aluminium can reduce MgO above 1500 degrees Celsius. From Ellingham diagram, it is very clear, aluminium below 1500 Kelvin, below this point A, aluminium comes above the line of MgO. We know the rule, the reducing agent should come below the metal oxide, but here aluminium comes above the metal oxide. So we cannot use aluminium for reducing MgO below the point A or below the temperature 1500 Kelvin. But above 1500 Kelvin, there is a change in the direction of line. MgO comes above Al2O3, so Al comes below MgO, so we can use aluminium for reducing MgO after the point A or after the temperature 1500 Kelvin. So it depends on the temperature also, the choice of reducing agent will change. And Ellingham diagram, and we are coming to the last section of Ellingham diagram. Before that, two important points. In this diagram we can see some straight line, but in somewhere you can see a slight change in the slope. For example, one here, second one is here, third one is here. Actually this changes in this straight line, and this change is due to change in phase transition, because a solid form of compound will change to liquid form will change to gas. That change you can observe in delta G value. MgO, this change is due to change in phase, solid to liquid, liquid to gas, gas to liquid. Due to that change you can see a change in the delta G value and also a change in the line. And next very important point is, any metal will reduce an oxide of another metal that lies above it in Ellingham diagram. That means any metal which reduce oxide of another metal, that oxide will lie in above the line of metal. Clear? One more time I will tell. Any metal here magnesium which reduce metal oxide, that metal oxide will lies above that metal. That means the metal oxide always lie above the reducing agent. By using this point we can explain these two things. Aluminium reduces FeO by aluminium here, and metal oxide is above, so aluminium can reduce FeO. And aluminium cannot reduce MgO. Why? Because aluminium, the reducing agent top and metal oxides are below, so aluminium cannot reduce MgO. Another example I can tell, Cu2O. Metal oxide line is near to zero or above in Ellingham diagram, so we can use carbon monoxide, carbon. We can use more reducing agent for reducing copper oxide, because all reducing agents comes below the line of Cu2O. So this shortcut will help you to find out choice of reducing agent from Ellingham diagram without calculation also. Ellingham diagram mainly have two limitations. The first limitation is it does not explain the rate or speed of reaction. It explains only one point, reaction possible or not, but doesn't explain the speed, how much fast a reaction will take place. Second thing is, this full theory considered that reactants and products are in equilibrium, but always reactants and products will not come to equilibrium. So these are some limitations of Ellingham diagram. Now you can check your knowledge related to Ellingham diagram by using this question. It's a MCQ or entrance based question, so thoroughly read these questions, and by using this diagram you find out the answer. There are three questions, you find out the answer. Okay, take it as a homework. Thank you.